What's going on, guys? Wingsman here, and welcome back to another wrestling tutorial. And today, guys, I'm gonna be showing you how to make this really cool and simple 4x4 chest door in Minecraft Bedrock Edition. If you guys are excited for that, make sure to drop a like down below and subscribe if you're new. I noticed that over 91% of you guys that watch my channel are actually not subscribed. So what are you doing? It's completely free, takes less than a second, and helps the channel tremendously. And with all that said, let's get right into today's video. Yes, we are back with another door, and I'm super excited about this one because this is a 4x4 chest door. And of course, the reason I absolutely love it is because it doubles as a door and as a form of storage. Yes, you can actually store items inside of these chests, and they are going to stay inside of them even though the chests are going to move out of the way. And it's fully up to you what you want to have behind this door. You can have a secret entrance, you can have a secret room. It's absolutely completely up to you. But of course, that doesn't mean that I don't have my personal favorite use for this door. You can see this is kind of like a storage door, and the best thing to have behind the storage door is of course more storage. You can just fill the whole room with chests, barrels, shortcut boxes, whatever you want. And of course, you can just have absolutely anything behind it. You can see the chest move out of the way, and maybe you can't reach some of them, but you are still gonna be able to reach all of these chests. You see, even if I put some redstone over here, we close the door, we are still going to have those items inside the chest where we actually put it in. And you can see, because the chests are not a full block and they are a bit smaller, you're gonna be able to see behind them, and you are gonna be able to see some redstone. So it might not be the best thing for the actual secret rooms because you can actually see it, but in my opinion it doesn't really matter because I kinda like to see the redstone and all the behind the scenes stuff happening. But again, you can have this door lead to absolutely anything, and the reason for this is really simple. All we have is two double piston extenders on either side connected with the redstone, having our little lever in the front. So you can see the reason for this is really simple, and I'm going to show you how to make it right now. So the blocks you're going to need for this are some block of a choice for the redstone and for the door. You're going to need some immovable blocks. I'm gonna be using light blue glass terracotta. But of course, you can use obsidian, leaves, pumpkins, or melons. We are going to need 8 sticky pistons, 8 slime blocks, 8 honey blocks, 16 chests, 14 redstone repeaters, 46 redstone dust, and 1 lever to activate our door. So we are going to start off 3 blocks away from the ground and have 2 sticky pistons just like this. This is going to be our first out of 4 double piston extenders. Then we want to go behind it and make a 3x3 platform for the redstone to go on. So just go ahead and do something like this. Grab yourself one redstone repeater, put it going into the first sticky piston on max tick delay. And for the second one, you want to double that, so we're going to need 2 repeaters on max tick delay. Grab yourself the redstone and just wrap it around like this. You can see when we activate it, we're going to get the double piston extension. And when deactivated, we're going to get the double piston retraction. What you want to do is actually keep these sticky pistons activated, that way you can put in the slime blocks and the honey blocks. We're going to have 8 of them. You can see we're going to have a 2x2 box of the actual slime blocks, then 2x2 of the honey blocks on top of that, and we're just going to alternate it one more time. So where you have the honey blocks, you want to have slime blocks next to it, and of course next to slime blocks you will want to have honey blocks, so it should look something like this. And all we have to do now is copy the double piston extender 3 more times. We want to go to the original double piston extender, have the block coming out of the first one, and have 2 more of the stick pistons on top of that. We're just going to create the same 3x3 platform for the redstone, only exception being that we are going to have to replace this block over here with an immovable block. Because you can see, when the slime blocks retract, they are going to get into the contact with this block, and we can't have it move because we're going to have redstone on top of it. And now we are just going to copy the redstone, having one repeater on max tick delay going into the first sticky piston and doubling that for the second one, meaning we're going to have 2 redstone repeaters on max tick delay. We can grab a set of redstone and just wrap it around, and of course we can test it out with the lever. We are going to get the double piston extension and the double piston retraction. And now we have to copy this exact same setup on the other side. And we're going to start off with the bottom double piston extender, so go to this honey block and build 5 blocks out. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Go ahead, destroy the first 4, and this is where we're going to put in our double piston extender, making sure that we're going to have that 2 block gap between the sticky piston and the honey block, or the slime block depending on which side you are on. And now we can make that 3x3 platform for the redstone to go on. Keep in mind that this is the bottom double piston extender, so we don't need to replace this block with the immovable one. Grab a save the redstone repeaters and have one redstone repeater on max tick delay going into the first sticky piston, two for the second one on max tick delay, and just wrap the redstone around, and we need to do that one more time. So go one block above of the original sticky piston and put in the two more, which is going to be our final double piston extender. Go ahead and copy the little platform on the bottom, and of course for this block we are going to need to make sure it's going to be an immovable one. We can do the same thing. One repeater on max tick delay for the first sticky piston and two for the other, and wrap the redstone around, and you are done as far as the double piston extenders go. And now we want to connect all of them together, starting off with the left side right here. We're going to extend one block away from this redstone dust and just make a little staircase going upwards. We just need two additional redstone dust to connect each of the double piston extenders. Of course we want to do the same thing on the other side, so just go ahead and copy the thing we did over there with three blocks and of course two pieces of redstone dust. Now you can save a block because you don't really need this one over here. And now all we have to do is just connect them using some redstone dust. So we're going to go two blocks down over here and another one on this side. So you can see we are just going to create a little staircase on both sides. We can just grab a save the redstone and go all the way across. And we're going to see, because this is an even number door, you are going to need two additional repeaters on this side just to extend the signal. Reason being is if you have an actual lever or any other activation system too far away and you just have the repeater on one side, the left side is not going to get enough power. But if you have the actual two repeaters over here splitting the signal, making sure that both of these sides are going to get the exact same signal strength, you can lead the redstone as far as you want. But if you have just one like this, you can see that this side is going to get one additional power and this one is not going to have enough. So depending on how far you want to go, you want to use two repeaters, but if you have the lever like two or three blocks away from the door, you can use just one repeater and the redstone is going to reach. But just to be safe, add two repeaters because they're really simple and don't really take that many resources, and you can be safe with one additional redstone dust. After you have done that, what this means is that every single double piston extender is connected together and we're going to have a really nice 4x4 door. Of course you can keep it like this, which is a really simple 4x4 door using honey blocks and slime blocks, or you can put any block that you actually want on this. Of course today we're gonna be going for the actual chests, and we're going to see that they're actually going to make the double chest right now, but as soon as we move them away they are never going to form them again. So it kind of looks a lot better than just having a couple of the actual double chests to me. So you can see when we move them they are all going to separate, and even if we push them together they are going to stay the same. And we only have one kind of the chest, we don't have the trap chests. So I guess this is an easy way to actually separate them, just you have to move them. And now all you have to do is just go and cover everything up. Of course if you are in survival these three blocks over here can be precious. But since this is a sliding door that actually goes left and right, you need to make sure that it's gonna be open, so that way the chest and the slime blocks can actually move through it. But of course you can cover up the top and the bottom, and then just use any block for your choice to cover everything up over here. So what I mean by that is you can't have the blocks over here, because when the door opens of course the chests are going to move it. So you want to go one block away from it and then put in like that little ring slash square around it to cover everything up. And then you can decide what you want to do and have on the other side. Now of course you want to have a tunnel that's going to cover every single piece of the redstone up, but you can have that tunnel go as far as you want, or of course you can just have it lead into a secret base or have a storage room behind this, which is totally my favorite idea. But because over here we have the slime blocks and the honey blocks, we want to have immovable blocks underneath them on the bottom and on the top, making sure we're not going to have any on the side. Reason being again, this is a sliding door that goes left and right. Now because we have only the immovable blocks at the top and the bottom, and that doesn't really look great to me, what I like to do is just add additional ring, even though we don't need them right here because slime blocks or honey blocks are not going to get into contact with them. But of course when they retract they are going to get in contact with these actual blocks on the side. So you can see without the actual immovable blocks on the bottom and the top it looks kinda ugly, because they are just one block away from each other. So just like to add this additional ring. And of course after that you can grab any block that you want, you can then just extend it, making sure it's going to go past the actual redstone dust. Just make sure you're not going to put any blocks over here, because you're going to cut off the signal, and because you don't really need it. If you put it on the wall over here and in the floor, you can see we're going to avoid cutting the signal, and we don't really need these blocks, and we can save some of them on the decoration. You can just go ahead, grab a saved block of your choice, and just go all the way around. Again, you can extend this as far as you want, and all we have to do right now is just go to the front and make sure we're going to have a platform for us to walk on, that we are going to cover all these sticky pistons up. So you can just go 3 additional blocks on either side, and we're going to see we're going to cover them up. Go ahead, do the same thing over here, and of course we want to put in a little platform for us to walk on. If you're doing this in survival, of course you're going to have the floor and the wall already by the chance. You just want to decide where you want to put in your lever. And just move it up. You can see we're just going to move it from this block to the one on the platform, and we're going to need additional block over here with the redstone on top of it. That way we can actually send a signal to the door, and we are pretty much done. So if you guys have enjoyed this video, make sure to drop a like down below and subscribe if you are new. I noticed that over 91% of you guys that watch my channel are actually not subscribed. So what are you doing? It's completely free, takes less than a second, and helps the channel out tremendously. And you can always change your mind later, so at least consider it. If you think any of your friends would enjoy this type of content, make sure to share with them. But as always, I really hope you enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.